Hello students, today we are going to start our next chapter, that is building finishes, which carries 8 marks. So in this whole chapter we are going to discuss about the floors and roofs and the wall finishes. In the floors and roof we are going to discuss about the types of floor finishes and its suitability, then the different types of the roof coverings. Then, in the wall finish, we are going to learn about the plastering, the necessity of plastering, the procedure of plastering, then the different types of plasters, and then painting. So, these are the finishing processes which we are going to carry into the construction of a building when the whole work of building construction is completed. So this building finishes is an important part of the building construction. So in this chapter, first we are going to discuss about the floors. Different types of the finish such as mortar finish, mosaic finish, timber finish, etc. are used in the different thickness for different purpose of the floors. The types of the floors for the workshop is Shahabad flooring. For the temple, it will be granite flooring. For the hotel, it is again a granite. For the drawing halls, it will be marble flooring. So floors, so these are the, this is the part of the building finish on which the occupants are moving from here and there. So this flooring, this is carried out with the help of a mortar finish or mosaic finish, timber finish, etc. For the flooring purpose, today we are using the different types of the tiles available into the market. So as the functioning of the floor changes, the type of the tile is also changes. So depending on the function of the floor, which type of the tile we are going to fix on it, it is decided. So there are different types of the flooring tiles used into the construction purpose. So first of all, the various types of the floors are mud floor, wood floor, stone floor, and concrete floor. So these are the different materials which we are going to use for the flooring purposes. First of all, the mud floor. So no great skill is required in this construction. Cheap in the construction and maintenance, raw material is easily available. Thus, these flooring are very popular in the villages. So, in the old ages where the tiles are not available, on that time, the mud flooring is used. So, for this purpose, no great skill is required to carry out the flooring work. It is cheap and cheap in the construction as well as into the maintenance, and the raw material is easily available. Thus, the flooring are very popular into the villages. The wood floors, such type of flooring is used for auditoriums, dance halls, gymnasium floors, etc. So wood flooring, it is a type of flooring in which wood is used as a flooring material, and this type of the materials or this type of the flooring, it is used into the auditoriums, dance halls, gymnasiums, etc. The stone flooring, this is a rough type of stone flooring used in godown sheds and stores, etc., where the heavy load is there on the floor. At that time we are using the stone flooring. Concrete flooring, this type of the flooring is commonly used both in the residential and public building. Now the different types of floor finishes which are used into the construction of the floors. So these are the different types of the tiles which are used into the construction of the floors. Then Shahabad flooring, Kota flooring, marble flooring, granite flooring, kadapa, mosaic tiles, pavement blocks, tiled flooring, trimix flooring, vitrified tiles, skirting, dado, mezzanine, and ceramic. So these are some of the materials which are used into the floor finishes. First of all, the cota flooring. This is commonly used for the paving of the floor steps in the residential buildings. Marble flooring, it is used in the residential building, hospitals, then temples, etc., where the superior types of the flooring and where the extra cleanliness is an essential requirement. Granite flooring, it is commonly used for paving the floors in commercial buildings such as hotels, offices, at the entrance of the hospitals, etc., and also used as a flooring material in the temples. Kadapa flooring, this is used for making kitchen platforms, pavement for interlocking blocks, for the parking areas, footpath areas at the junctions of the traffic signals. Tiled flooring, this type of flooring purpose in the residential and public buildings. Trimix flooring for high quality concrete floors. Vitrified tiles used into the kitchen and bathroom. So these are the various places on which the different types of the flooring materials are used according to the requirement. Then, method of laying the floors. The methods of laying the floors in this first procedure, that is the ground preparation. Second, that is the laying and construction. Third, polishing. And last, that is the curing. So, ground preparation in this, first of all, the ground is prepared for the fixing of the tiles over it. So, ground preparation, it is carried out with the help of grit material or the sand which is used into the construction. After the ground preparation, on that, the laying and construction of the flooring tiles, it is done. Then, after laying and fixing of flooring tiles onto the floors, the polishing of the floor is carried out. And lastly, the curing is carried out for properly fixing of the floors. Now, the next part from the chapter, that is the roof. First of all, introduction. It may be defined as the uppermost part of the building provided as a structural covering to protect the building from weather. Structurally, a roof is constructed in the same way as an upper floor, though the shape of its upper surface may be different. The roof consists of structural elements which supports the roof is the roof covering. The roof covering may be of AC sheets, GI sheets, wooden shings, tiles, slab itself. So the roof, that is the topmost part or the uppermost part of the building which provide a structural covering to protect the building from the weather. Structurally, this roof, it is constructed in the same way as an upper floor. So the shape of it may be different. Roof consists of structural elements which supports the roof in the roof coverings. The roof coverings may be of AC GI sheets, wooden roof we can provide, tiles, and the slab itself will act as a roof. The types of the roofs, there are three types of the roofs: pitched roof, flat or terraced roof, and curved roof. First of all, the pitched roof. A sloping roof is known as a pitched roof. These are suitable in those areas where rainfall, snowfall is very heavy. So, pitched roofs are these roofs which are having their surface as inclined downward. As the where the heavy rainfall occurs, on that places the pitched roofs are provided, so that whatever the water coming on the roofs, that can be drained off easily. So in this image, you can see the various parts of the pitched roofs. Also, you can see one flat roof in this also. So here you can see the gable, ridge, then valley, hipped end, heath, eaves, soffits and the dormer. So these are the various parts of the pitched roofs which we are going to see in this figure. Then the pitched roofs may be a king post or queen post, etc. So the king post truss. In this type of the truss, the central post known as a king post forms support for the tie beam. The inclined members known as the struts prevents the principal rafters from building into the middle. The king post truss suitable for the roofs of span varying from 5 to 8 meter as shown in the figure. So these are the some types of the pitched roofs, that is the king post truss, queen post truss, etc. So in this king post truss, this type of the truss, the central post is known as a king post, which support from the tie beam. The inclined members known as the struts prevents the principal rafters from bending in the middle. A king post truss suitable for roofs of the span varying from 5 to 8 meter as shown in the figure. So this is a figure in which you can see the king post truss, in which the vertical member which is provided, that is known as the king post, the inclined members which are provided known as a strut, then the horizontal member known as a tie beam, then the supporting walls are there, and on this king post we are providing the GI sheets or AC sheets for the roofing purpose. So in this figure you can see the different parts of the king post truss. Now the next part of this we will see into the next lecture. Today we will stop over here. Thank you.